Hello and welcome back to another episode of MFPE. And today we're not going to do Dark Vision anymore. So this is the trial, The Scorn of Aemon. This fight pretty good. It's very fun. It's very hard. But the only thing that I don't like here is the turn limitation. It requires that you need to have multiple of meta units to pass this turn limitation mission. And moreover, this strategy is not for me originally.It comes from the Mega Trade Scorn of Aemon in Reddit, and the one that provides this strategy is Orzhov Karlov. Sorry if I'm misspelling your name, but your strategy is amazing. Thanks for that too. This strategy requires Eric Brother, Arden, Beatrix, Arche, and Finera. And we don't need Reflecting. That's very important to me because I don't have Reflecting in my inventory.Okay, this is a 6 turn kill. You need to have a very strong Arden. So, I don't have Arden myself. I use my friend's Arden to pass this. Okay, let's start with the first unit. Vanilla will be a DPS in her normal form. She needs only the Undead Killer. You don't even need to give her the Limit Burst Damage boost. We don't need that. In her bare form, she also a DPS.The most important here is you need to equip her with Rage Speed Thrower. This skill is a single target dispel herself at one ally. And we need to dispel on our provoke tank because Aemon going to do a preemptive zombie and regen. If you don't dispel that regen, it will instantly kill your party member. Princess Arche is a physical evasion and provoke tank. Your provoke tank need to haveDeath resist, so I give her Genji shield. And because Arche need to use Dark Shard. Dark Shard is her Netherside skill. It needs like 500 MP. That requires a lot of MP. So I give her 3 stars. So this actually reduce MP consumption for 50% and give a 33% MP. Her material is a lot of MP fill and MP regen alongside with evasion and provoke gear.Eric Butter in normal form is a DPS. You need to equip him with anti-decay amulet. Because I'm not sure turn 2 or turn 3 boss going to do all break to you. Your DPS need to have this to prevent attack and magic break. Because nobody in my team able to do a break resist, so that's why we need this equipment. Not only that, he need a lot of limit field gear. So I give him 3 mood maker and Lumina STMR.He unable to fill his limit gauge in 3 turns. That is pretty hard. Okay, on his bare form, this is a fully gear for the DPS. So give him limit burst damage boost and undead killer. Beatrix is a magic cover tank. In this form, she is a magic cover tank too.Your magic cover tank need to have 200% resistance on 4 elements, which are fire, water, wind, and earth. But as you can see here, my earth resistance is only 190%. It's still okay to take that 10% damage, don't worry. And in this form, she need like 4,000 attack and 1,500 or more spirit to tank the Ultima and Meteor.My gear is pretty decent. She has 2400 spirit, that's more than enough. And 4500 attack make her become a support DPS that helps you deal damage in the burst turn. Winry Earring is very good here because it keeps a lot of elemental resistance. 3 out of 4 is the direct element that we need. And for her material, she needs a lot of STMR for the elemental resistance gear.On her bare form, she needs only 200% resistance on fire, wind, water, and earth. That's all what she needs in here. So we're going to stay in this form only on a cover turn. Other than that, we're going to stay in her normal form. And our friends Arden who carry me past this trial. And thanks to this Arden, his gear is amazing.Your Arden need to gear with anti-decay amulet for break resistance in normal form. In brave form, he is a DPS gear with jump damage boost and undead killer. And the final one is Vaynara and B technique to start on her brave form. Okay, let's go. Alright, Amon will start a fight with preemptive zombie and regeneration. If you don't dispel that regen, it will instantly kill your provoke tank. So we're going to start turn with Vaynara, so let's use Rage Beat Roar 2D. Dispel that regen from Archer. Speed Hit will cover, so let's use Shelga and cover magic. Eric Rather going to do a buff, so we use Soul Transmutation and 2 Tag Chain to generate Limit Crystal. Then use his Limit Burst for Source and Pearl. And this is special because we going to dual cast Archer this turn, this and only turn. We going to use that Wind Element skill to clear the Wind Element Attack mission and Dark Shard for a 3 stack meta sign. One more thing that I did not talk about is Amon will random 4 elemental attack. He will use one of them, not all of them. For example, this turn he may use fire attack. Next turn he may use water attack. It's random. I can't say that which turn that he going to use that element attack. On turn 2, let's start with Vaynara, shift back to her normal form and triple cast to start that regenerating move and her magma ability. BTK also shift back to normal form and triple cast start that regenerating move. Yeah, I think Sarate is okay. We don't need anything from her. And let's change first to generate Limit Crystal for Eric Brother. Eric Brother needs to stay in normal form because we build him for a Limit Field gear. Alright, let's start fulfill Eric Brother. Cool. Let me chip back to brave form and we're going to start imbuild. So let you get up Uranovic to buff limit burst damage, imbuild fire and tag chain. Alright, after everything finished, jump Ardyn. And Princess Archer, from now on you're going to do a dark charge only. Okay, we ready to burst on next turn. Alright, on turn 3, Eric Butter going to use his limit burst in his brave form. Vaynara going to use triple cast, one of her cooldown and 2 condemning breath. BTK also triple cast her Stardust Ray Shining Moon. Alright, chain Stardust Ray first. And then send Eric Brother. After C 300% on screen, send Ardyn. This should start more than 50%. Because Amon going to dispel your team after you pass 50% threshold. We need him to dispel at this turn because next turn we're going to buff Ardyn attack again. And as you can see here, that is a Wind Elemental attack that he random use. And after you pass 50% threshold, he's going to use Meteor, which is a non-elemental magic attack. So that's why we need High Spirit on Beatrix. Okay, on turn 4, let's start with Ardyn. Chip back? No. For Ardyn, we need to buff attack. Yes, his cooldown on his brave form is the skill that buff attack. Because Amon dispel at this turn, we going to do a rebuff and re-imbuild. And Eric Brother going to imbuild water now. Oh, a thing that I forget to mention again. On first 3 turn, Amon is weak to fire. And turn 4, turn 5, turn 6, he going to weak on water. Turn 7, turn 8, turn 9, he going to weak on wind. and 10, 11, 12 is going to weak on the earth element. It's going to be a rotation like this, so that's why we need to imbue water here. When we're going to do triple cast 2 of her condemning blade and magnet ability. Beat is going to shift to brave form and recast cover, so this time we're going to use cover magic and sally protection. Ashe, let's use dark shot again. She is net aside bot this time. Why we need triple net aside? Because Aemon going to random use 2 white magic, which is full life and Kyoja, and all of them going to instant kill your party member, so that's why we need 3 net aside to prevent. And because of we pass the 15% threshold, we get a meteor this turn too. I think we pass 2 threshold, which is 75 and 15%, so that's why we get meteor 2 turns. Okay, on turn 5, this time we're going to fill Eric limit gauge with his skill. So use the this fight you lose to fill his limit gauge. And use tag chain 2 times to deal some damage. When we're not going to do the same thing, triple cast 2 of condemning blade and her magnus ability. BTK chip back to normal form and triple cast startup ray chaining move. We need to do that because Aemon going to get a 5 stack of mirage. We need to clear that with 5 normal attack or 5 skills. Then going to jump up this turn and Ashe going to do dark shot again. Alright, this is a kill turn. Eric Barton used limit burst on his brave form. Vanara triple cast her starter and chaining move alongside with Beatrix. Chain both of them together. Send Eric Barton. And when you see 300%, send Arden. Wow, that's really close, but we've done it. 6 turn kill. I have to say sorry that if you can't kill in turn 6, it's quite like a disaster. Because on turn 7, 8, 9, boss weak to win element, but nobody in your team able to do a win imbue. You need to wait until turn like 10, 11, 12 to get the earth again. That you can use a rebutter to do an earth imbue. But we pass here. Thanks for my friend Ardin, 3 star with her bed in slot gear. Thank you again for all of Karloff to the strategy in the Reddit. Okay, that is Aemon, the latest fight for us in global server. Thanks for watching and bye.